lifestyle is threatened. Is cheap overseas labor to blame?
American mothers don't want their daughters to be in sewing plants.
Can Americans win in today's global economy? Or is it too late?
So, who will be the leader in 20 years? Nobody knows.
Will we ever again be able to proudly say, Made in America? Major funding for Made in America is provided by the Alfred P. Sloan Foundation, which supports these programs as a contribution to public understanding of technology and industry. Additional funding provided by the Carnegie Corporation of New York and the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and viewers like you. Corporate funding is provided by the Chubb Group of Insurance Companies for over 100 years providing business and personal insurance through global markets.
Seventh Avenue, New York. The Garment District, the heart of one of America's oldest industries. It's fall in New York City, which means it's time to think about clothes for spring. It's all part of the fashion cycle, 7th Avenue's perpetual motion machine. From couture to cape, $1 billion a year on clothes. There's a lot of money to be made on the basic necessities, and so clothing is big business. In fact, it's many businesses, big and small, woven together all over the world. I'm Robert Reich. Tonight on Made in America, we examine what American competitiveness really means in a world in which more and more industries are becoming global, where people work together across borders to produce products that are international creations. This fundamental transformation is affecting all of us. Some are doing better and better. Others are getting left behind. We may even be bringing up the first generation of Americans who are not as well off as their parents. Who's making it in America and who's not as the rules of the economic game change? For an answer, we go behind the scenes of the international rag trade. We follow the making of this dress and one complete fashion cycle. We weave a story of many threads, beginning here. 550 7th Avenue, the most high-profile address in the Garment District. Across the street is a bronze sculpture of a sewer, reminiscent of a time when America made most of its clothes within its own borders. But now in buildings like this, it seems that more deals get made than garments. Many involve the biggest names in the business.
Listen, all of this is supposed to come over here.
Meet Bill Blass, one of America's most famous fashion designers.
Tuck the pin there and there. Cut a piece of this.
Yes.
No, cut a piece of this so I can take this through here. Understand?
Okay. So I cut...
Blass is creating a gown for his collection.
This is, look at this in the front here, Shandy. This isn't anything. This is just a piece of nothing. It has to be.
I have to cut.
Okay. And that solves this problem.
Blass must put the finishing touches on this and 80 other pieces in the next 2 weeks to show his well-to-do clientele.
Can you come and we'll try this?
Most of my customers certainly don't need clothes, but they do have to be seduced into buying them. And it has to be that they have a good investment suit. This is the way. Now, this is classic, and this is sort of typical Bill Blass. No matter what anybody else shows or does, this is the sort of thing, sort of way I like to see a gal look.
Bold colors, classic shapes, the signature look for Bill Blass originals. The price? From $3,700 for this suit.
For the woman who wants something a little bit more snappy, the more eye appeal.
To $9,000 for some evening gowns.
See that?
These price tags may shock, but Bill Blass's customers have never had it better. Many are among America's richest 1%, families making more than $550,000 a year.
White suit takes you to dinner, takes you any place. While it looks good at the races or at Ascot or something like that.
Still, selling expensive clothes to wealthy customers isn't what makes a designer really rich. It's a very small market. In the high fashion business, you cash in on your fame by selling your name. One company that has bought the prestigious Bill Blass name is the Hero Group.
Well, that's Bill's whole new thing with the movement from the...
Hero, which makes less expensive designer label clothes, owns the Bill Blass license for sportswear and dresses. Hero's Blass division president, Gerald Buxbaum, and dress designer Sully Bonnelly meet with Blass to select fabrics for holiday and resort, the two fashion seasons between fall and spring.
Well, you think it's too heavy, Bill? Maybe if we'd infuse it or something, it might be okay.
I think it's an awfully heavy crate for dresses.
Okay.
This is the first step in creating a new collection.
You know, and then there are things like this. And
hate it.
I don't like it.
Yeah, guys.
Don't even like the jacket. It's too modest.
It's very pedestrian.
It's timid. It has no guts.
Okay.
I hate that.
Okay. And,
the Hero Group says Blass personally okays everything in the lines. Well, almost everything.
On the daytime, we talk about wool crepe.
You can sell wool crepe. It ain't the youngest fabric.
But if we do it like you're doing those color block dresses in an interesting way.
But why do it in wool crepe, which is already an old fabric? Why don't you just do it in a...
How about if we combine it, you know, like with a silk scarf or something like
Sounds
that?
Sounds old to me. It doesn't have the snap and appeal for a young woman. The connotation isn't young.
Okay.
And that's what we're about, to make the youngest possible clothes. In this category of dresses, I have to be very leery of wool crepe. Even for daytime, you can come up with all kinds of other daytime fabrics that are acceptable, but not that.
Okay. So
now, well, that took care of that subject.
Yeah.
Well, not quite.
Love this.
Designer Sully Bonnelly still thinks the wool crepe will sell. He's guarded.
A simple shape that shows the body a little bit, and it has something to it without being too outrageous, and I think that makes it very rich looking. The dress, it could be one of the number ones on the line.
Well, now, when do we have the additional sketches in here?
When the sketches are shown to Blass, he thinks the line is too dull.
Okay.
But
and
we're
did
not
you
getting
see?
It.
Blass wants a more festive approach. Does it help to add a silk scarf to our wool crepe dress?
That's awfully quiet for this resort. I can't feel this.
Blass doesn't even like the scarf. Again, he pushes for jazzier ideas.
That is a sarong, for God's sake.
Sarong skirt?
Yeah. You don't have anything like that in this, and that's what's so necessary.
Yeah.
Even though Blass has different ideas, Hero keeps the wool dress in the line. With the design done,